police union chief has been molesting children since the 90s and they knew about it. Put up his picture. Okay, let me give you the background. Ex-Boston police union president has pleaded guilty to acts that he has committed for a span of 30 years and the cops knew about it. Patrick Rose, 67 years of age, faced a total of 33 charges in connection to rape and abuse of 6 children over various periods of time since the 90s. He pleaded guilty to 21 counts of child rape, sexual assault, and has been sentenced to 10 to 13 years. He should be sentenced until he dies, plus 10 years probation following his release. He previously pleaded not guilty and maintained his innocence, but changed his plea during a Superior Court appearance in Suffolk. Now, Rose, a former Boston police officer and president of the Boston Police Patrolmen's Association, was arrested on child sex charges in August of 2020. This came from allegations that he sexually assaulted a young relative starting when she was 7, okay? It was a family member. The victim, who is now a teenager, told police the assaults continued for 5 years until she turned 12. Rose allegedly touched her inappropriately, then asked her to perform sexual acts on him in his West Roxbury home. Rose was later charged with the rape and abuse of 5 other children. Prosecutors said most of the charges date back to the 90s, but at least one was within the last 2 years. Rose was allowed to remain on the force. I want you to hear this. He was allowed to remain on the force despite sufficient evidence found by internal investigators supporting allegations that he sexually assaulted a minor. That's according to documents released by the city last year. They released the documents. He gets investigated in the 90s. Internal affairs said he did it. He's guilty. What do they do? They let him remain on the job and then he becomes the head of the damn police union. Now, you still think these individuals are noble? Now, imagine if you are a good cop, right? With the Boston PD. You're a good cop. The guy who's in charge of your good cop coalition is an individual that other cops have proven by their investigation, he's actually a child molester. And you say nothing? You continue to pay dues to this person? You don't protest? You don't say, I won't pay another damn due until that molesting SOB is no longer our leader? None of you say that? And you call yourselves law enforcement officers. The irony of it all. There's more. Let's put up a picture of the black woman who was acting mayor in 2021 who ordered that release. Her name is Kim Janey. She ordered the internal affairs documentation to be released. Janey did so after the Boston Globe reported that Rose had been able to keep his badge despite a criminal complaint in 1995 for sexual assault on a 12-year-old child. The man likely has hundreds of victims. You know about some of them due to the investigation and the court pleading. But there are many you won't know about. They won't talk up, they won't say anything, they are ashamed, embarrassed. Criminal complaint was eventually dropped, but the department's internal affairs division concluded there was enough evidence to support the allegations according to the documents. Then Boston Police Commissioner Paul F. Evans was notified in a June 1996 memo of the results of the probe. Rose had been relieved of his weapon and placed on administrative duty, but was returned to full duty after an attorney for the Boston Police Patrolmen's Association wrote to the commissioner in October 1997 and threatened to file a grievance according to the documents. They are protecting a child molester. A city review of the Rose investigation led to a series of recommendations for keeping the department transparent. Among the changes recommended by the Office of Police Accountability and Transparency were starting investigations into officers charged with crimes within 48 hours and creating clear guidance on how officers should be punished. Now you need clear guidance. You need somebody to tell you how to lock his ass up when he commits child molestation. You need somebody to help you out here. You went to the police academy. You have post certification through the state. You get arrest powers. You get paid a paycheck to do a job. You went through the training modules, but you need some guidance here on how to successfully lock up a criminal who may in fact have a badge. Now you need help. We have covered so many of these stories on Indisputable of police officers who are engaged in sexual perversion, assault, molestation. The industry is so corrupt. And I get it. Obviously, there are some decent cops in the world. But if you say nothing when this type of culture permeates, you are not as good as you believe you are. Your silence is a cosign to the corruption. Jordan, thoughts here?
It's heartbreaking. I just was so disgusted when I read this. Just my heart goes out to the victims. That's just a really, really tough situation, especially if you're a kid. I've been there, so I get it. And it's really frustrating about I think this highlights the union structure in police. And when you have an internal review system and the way the unions are structured to prevent any sort of accountability, it leads to outcomes like this, whether it's murder or sex crimes or any other abuse of power or corruption. We really need to take a look at how we allow police unions to operate in this country, because they must be reformed. The way modern policing works, and even going back to the origins of modern policing, which has roots in Boston. I mean, what do? They just terrorized immigrant communities. And there's just from the beginnings of modern policing in this country, and even before that with the slave patrols, it has been about abuse of power and protecting capitalist interests. That's it. So we have to take a look at how we allow police unions to operate, because it's just an insider's club. They'll protect themselves. And like you say, if they don't call it out, they're just as guilty, because they're covering for despicable people and reprehensible actions.
That's right. And it seems as if people forget that police officers are public servants. They are servants of the public trust. And when they violate that public trust, they should be held to a higher standard of accountability and not a lower.